Welcome to this service. At entrance, you should tell, Heavenly Father God, let your mercy be upon us. Give the dead peace and rest. Give the churches unity and give the world peace. Amen, amen, amen. Pray about your enemies. Lord, listen to what I say to you. I am upset, so think about what I am saying. My King and my God, listen to my voice. I am asking you to help me. I am praying to you. Lord, every morning you listen to my voice. At sunrise, I will turn to you for help, and I will wait for you to answer. My God, you do not like anything that is bad. Evil people cannot live near you. Proud people cannot stand in front of you. God, you hate everyone who does evil things. You destroy those who tell lies. The Lord hates those who murder others and those who deceive others. Let us pray the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our heart by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer of penitence. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Confession. Father Eternal, Giver of Light and Grace, we have sinned in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and mirrored your images in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past and lead us out from darkness to walk in children of light. Amen. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Glory to God in the highest and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Gloria, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Amen. But I will come into your house because of your faithful love. I will bend low in your holy temple and I will worship you. Lord, help me to follow your right way. My enemies are waiting to attack me. Show the right way clearly to me so that I do not go the wrong way. My enemies never speak what is true. They only want to destroy people. Their mouth has the smell of an open grave. Their tongues say sweet things, but they are all lies. God say that they are guilty. Let their own ideas bring punishment to them. send them away because they do so many bad things. Yes, they have turned against you, but make people who turn to you happy. Make them always sing with joy because you keep them safe. Take care of those who truly love you. Then they will be really happy. Lord, you bless those who live in a right way. Your love is like a shield that keeps them safe. Amen. The Bible, Matthew chapter 4, Temptation of Jesus. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted there by the devil. For 40 days and 40 nights he fasted and became very hungry. During that time the devil came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become loaves of bread." But Jesus told him, "No, the scriptures say, people do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city, Jerusalem, to the highest point of the temple and said, "If you are the Son of God, jump off, for the scriptures say, he will order his angels to protect you and they will hold you up with their hands so you won't even hurt your foot on a stone." Jesus responded, "The scriptures also say, you must not test the Lord your God." Next, the devil took him to the peak of a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. "I will give all to you," he said, "if you will kneel down and worship me." "Get out of here, Satan," Jesus told him, "for the scriptures say, you must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil went away, and angels came and took care of Jesus. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Epistle, Romans 1, part 21-32. Paul says, "Yes, they know God, but they wouldn't worship him as God or even give him thanks. And they began to think up foolish ideas of what God was like. As a result, their minds became dark and confused. Claiming to the wise, they instead became utter fools, and instead of worshipping the glorious, ever-living God, they worship idols made to look like mere people and birds and animals and reptiles. So God abandoned them to do whatever shameful things their heart desired. As a result, they did vile and degrading things with each other's bodies. They traded the truth about God for a lie. So they worshipped and served the things God created instead of the Creator himself, who is worthy of eternal praise. That is why God abandoned them to their shameful desires. Even the women turned against the natural way to have sex and instead indulged in sex with each other. And the men, instead of having normal sexual relations with women, burned with lust for each other. Men did shameful things with other men, and as a result of this sin, they suffered within themselves the penalty they deserved. Since they thought it foolish to acknowledge God, he abandoned them to their foolish thinking and let them do things that should never be done. Their lives became full of every kind of weakness, sin, greed, hate, envy, murder, quarreling, deception, malicious behavior, and gossip. They are backstabbers, haters of God, insolent, proud, and boastful. They invent new ways of sinning and they disobey their parents. They refuse to understand, break their promises, and heartless, and have no mercy. They know God's justice requires that those who do those things deserve to die, yet they do them anyway. Worse yet, they encourage others to do them too. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Gospel, John 2, part 13 to 22. Jesus clears the temple. It was nearly time for the Jewish Passover celebration, so Jesus went to Jerusalem. In the temple area, he saw merchants selling cattle, sheep, and doves and for sacrifices. He also saw dealers at tables exchanging foreign money. Jesus made a whip from some ropes and chased them all out of the temple. He drove out the sheep and cattle, scattered the money changers' coins over the floor, and turned over their tables. Then, going over to the people who sold doves, he told them, "Get these things out of here. Stop turning my father's house into a marketplace." Then his disciples remembered this prophecy from the scriptures, "Passion for God's house will consume me." But the Jewish leader demanded, "What are you doing? If God gave you authority to do this, show us a miraculous sign to prove it." "All right," Jesus replied, "destroy this temple and in 3 days I will raise it up." "What?" they exclaimed. "It has taken 46 years to build this temple and you can rebuild it in 3 days? But when Jesus said this temple, he meant his own body after he was raised from the dead. His disciples remembered he had said this, and they believed both the scriptures and what Jesus had said. Glory to you, O Lord. David prays for health. "Lord, when you are angry, please do not punish me. I do not feel strong, Lord, so please be kind to me. Lord, please make me well again. Even my bones are shaking. I am very frightened. Lord, when will you do something to help me? Lord, turn back to me. Give me back my life. Make me safe because of your faithful love. Amen. If I die, I will no longer even remember you. Nobody can praise you in their grave. I am crying so much that I have no more strength. My bed becomes wet because I weep all night. My tears run into my pillow. I am so sad that my eyes do not see well anymore. They are becoming weak because of all my enemies." Preaching. Christ is not religion, only the way to heaven by having God's words with you. Christ has given us a lot of examples in the Bible to how we should live and has led us to heaven. Each time you see sinners, lead them to the right way and let them know that Jesus loves them. Let all your needs in the hands of God and Jesus and trust on their timing. Each time you're down, sing, Jesus, I love you. Jesus is love. Jesus is life. Jesus is whole, glorious. Each time you feel abandoned, sing, Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I trust you. Jesus, I believe you. Jesus, I have hope to you. Jesus, my holy Lord. Jesus, my only Lord. Each time you feel evil spirit, tell, go away, Satan. I am busy with angels in heaven. Amen. The Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Go away from me, you people who do wicked things. Now the Lord has heard me when I weep. I ask the Lord to be kind and to help me. Now he has answered me. May the Lord cause all my enemies to become ashamed. May they go away from me in fear. May shame suddenly come to them. God always does what is right. Lord, my God, I come to you to keep me safe. Please save me from all those people who want to catch me. If you do not keep me safe, my enemies will tear me in pieces. They will attack me like lions do, and nobody will be able to save me. Prayers of intercessions. We pray for the whole world to solve their conflicts and live in peace and grace. Thanks, Lord, hearing and answering our prayers. We pray for all poor countries. Give them rain and let them use it usefully to make food. Thanks, Lord, hearing and answering our prayers. We pray for sick people. Please heal them and let them know your miracles and let them adore you. Thanks, Lord, hearing and answering our prayers. Amen. The peace. We are the body of Christ. In the one spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes us for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always be with you. Amen. Preparation of taking the bread and wine. You must have a piece of bread and a glass of non-alcoholic wine or water. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be with God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this vine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. Your Lord is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord is here, His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Amen. It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise. Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For He is your living Word. Through Him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through Him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving Him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised Him from the dead and exalted Him to your right hand of high. Through Him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possessions. Therefore, we angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing, Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our salvation, Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who is in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, He took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember this offering of Himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim His mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of our kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Amen. Accept through Him, our great High Lord, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise, and as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Him and with Him and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. If you are many, break the bread and share with each other. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Son of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Son of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Amen. Giving of communion. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that He may live in us and we in Him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. You can eat the bread and drink the wine or water. If it is water you are drinking, you can ask Jesus to turn as wine in your body. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. It is the end of the service. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Jesus, amen. Lord my God, if I have done a wrong thing, then let my enemies chase me and catch me. If I have done a bad thing against a friend, or I helped his enemies who wanted to hurt him, then let my enemies catch me. They can knock me down to the ground. They can leave me there as a dead person in the dirt. But Lord, now do something. Wake up and help me. Show how angry you are against my enemies. Punish them in the way that you know is right. Bring together the people of all nations to stand in front of you. Rule over them from high above. You, Lord, judge the people of all nations. Lord, Most High God, show that I am not guilty. Show that I am righteous and honest. At exit, you should tell, I give over my past to the mercy of God, my presence for the love of God, and my future of God's protection. Amen.